Great to have you here on The Breakfast once again. Thanks for joining us. It's now time for Off the Press, where we have a review of the major stories making headlines across Nigeria today. And starting this morning with the Punch newspapers, just before we introduce our guest. Should be on your screen in just a few seconds. The big one there is talking about the ASUU strike. It says, strike. ASUU accuses federal government of deceit as minister explains payment delay. Government dishonest. Transferring money from CBN shouldn't be difficult. University lecturers insist. We'll make our decisions known. Today's ultimatum stands, Academic Staff Union of Universities is saying. Also, government pursuing CBN to disburse revitalization fund, says Education Minister. Airlines suffer 28.5% drop in domestic aircraft movement. Also, conflicting judgments, NBA to meet CJN, Mohammed summons six chief judges. Federal government presents budget October, targets 3 billion euros from euro bonds. Also, 21-day notice, NMA blames federal government, false suit. Still on the Punch this morning, Lagos NAFDAC shot toxic chemical plant, arrest 4. NDA invasion, more troubles coming, Fadambaka warns. Also, DSS bows to pressure, releases 80 Boho's aides. Still on the Punch, Autumn fumes as Akume calls for emergency rule in Benue. Lagos transport worker dies during fight over 500 naira bet. And finally, Amechi's confession confirmed deep corruption in Buhari's regime, says the PDP. Now on the Nigerian Tribune this morning, September 1st, anti-open grazing deadline, where southern states stand. Conflicting court orders, CJN summons chief judges of Rivers, Kebbi, Imo, Anambra, and two other states. Also this morning, Kano has 2 million drug addicts, says the NDLEA boss. Nigerian government must end crimes of enforced disappearance, says Amnesty International. DSS releases 8 out of 12 associates of Igboho. And also, Plateau State military warns residents against self-defense. I'd like our guests to definitely speak on that one. CBN unveils guidelines, sets transfer limits for e-Naira. Akume, other APC leaders demand state of emergency in Benue. All right, from the Tribune, let's move over to the Nation newspapers. Mark Parnell links PDP crisis to Wike Secundus. Crazy bills. Residents shot Akure BEDC office. And also, fourth week of Southeast Ghost Monday turns bloody. Still on the Nation this morning, retrieve arms from repentant terrorist. And that's from the Borno State Governor. Finance Minister, economy on recovery path and growing. Federal government to finance 2022 budget deficit with 6.1 billion euros. And finally, on the Nation, court rejects Malami's application to vacate order on Igboho. Ondo makes COVID-19 vaccination compulsory. I'm going to quickly just throw in a few from the Daily Independent this morning. Structural imbalances overshadow 2021 GDP growth. 5.01% GDP to be felt on industries and unemployment drop, says the federal government. Says we are borrowing sensibly, investing in infrastructure and others. PDP stakeholders move to zone chairmanship position to North, want party to throw presidential ticket open. Also on the Daily Independent, party crisis, CJN summons six chief judges over conflicting orders. 80 Boho's aides freed from DSS custody. Again, courts rejects AGF and DSS plea to arrest Sunday Igboho. Still on the Daily Independent, banks, markets close in Enugu despite suspension of sit-at-home order. And then CBN names BIT Incorporated technical partner for digital currency project. Encourage more Boko Haram members to surrender, says Lawan. I'm going to stop there so we can quickly bring in our guest this morning, Chris Wandu, publisher of CKN News. Thanks for joining us. Good morning to you, sir.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
All right. So it's not a story that has made all the papers, but I think it's an interesting one. And that is the story in the Nation, or the Tribune rather, saying Plateau State military warns residents against self-defense. Quickly, let's have your thoughts on that story first.
Well, if the rent against self-defense, what mechanism are they putting in place to be able to make sure that they're secure? Have they been able to secure the state? On a daily basis, they are getting killed in their tent, and the military and the police and all the security agencies seem hopeless and helpless in the situation. You are telling me to just keep my hand at go. Why people come to my house to slaughter me, and I will not defend myself? There is nowhere in the world. This is what happened. That's what such happened. Every human being has a right to defend himself when being attacked. So the only way they can be able to defend themselves is making sure that those coming after them, to kill them for whatever reason, they retaliate or be able to defend themselves. So that coming from the military to me is a no-no. It doesn't make sense.
Yeah, but Mr. Wandu, is this the army?
Security to secure my life. That is the only one I would listen to. That.
Yeah, this is what I want to get. Is this, you know, does this sound like the army is equating self-defense to reprisal attacks?
Whichever one they're saying, the statement is that people should not go into self-defense. So whether it's reprisal attacks or normal defense against assault, killing, the fact is that people have rights to defend themselves. So the military, as it were, will not sit in their barracks and then see people coming to rampage their barracks, and they say, no, we not attack back, or we will not defend ourselves. So, and even at that, it is not the ability of the military to say the responsibility for security of life and property within the country is the of the police. The army practically or duty has not their mandate is to defend the country against external aggression. It's not every time that you get the military to get engaged in civil issues, internal security, but that is where we find ourselves because of the peculiar situation we're in. But ordinarily, that has really come to police, as long as it may be, but that might still be big, but coming from the army. Army has not to do with internal security in any part of the world. So they are helping other internal security agencies that we need to be able to make sure that there is law and order. But asking people to come not dependent, I don't think they are serious about that.
All right, still talking security now. Let's move to Benue, where there's a story saying Akume and other APC leaders demand state of emergency in Benue. Governor Otom has of course, reacted to that and spoken against it. And, you know, basically painted it, you know, as a political struggle or, you know, as the APC's way of trying to derail his government in the state. What are your thoughts?
APC is in charge. Security across, at least the security agency is under the control of the federal government. You're talking of me now, the Navy, NSDC, name it. They are under command of the commander in chief of the armed forces, who is the president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. In this case, the president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, an APC member, and the president Muhammadu Buhari. For you to now say you want to declare a state of emergency, then the blame should go to any rule of the president, the federal government, because the state government has no single security apparatus except to set up all these local vigilantes being set up by several other states. But come to think of it, have also the APC friends, have us all for a declaration of state of emergency in Katsina, in Borno, even in Zamfara, and so many northern Nigerian people are being on a daily basis. Have they also displayed that in fact that has become a battleground and is killing a killing theater of people? of which recently some pilot and some other and some others were killed. So when they make this statement, that you can't continue to wonder, could that be part of the problem? Is that the whole idea? Because sure, you are not that probably what are the insecurity within the more engineer by result engineer by that so that the state of emergency can be declared as a. I think our leaders should be very, very careful in their utterance. They should be part of the solution and not part of the problem. I don't know what the government of Benin State. They knew what happened. It's so important. There are so many. They ask that in the state of emergency.
Also, bear in mind, in the last few weeks, there has been a back and forth between the Benue State Governor Otom and the federal government, basically exchanging words here and there. And that's one of the things that also.
Don't forget that Akume is also a minister under government. I'm saying that forget that Akume is the minister under this government. So definitely back the government against the government is another part. So that's not the right. You have heard that that statement. That we should be talking. What has it done to be able to give some level of solutions to the problem? If there's a problem, has it come the solution to the statement and they do not address it? So for me, it's not that yet. It's just being completely correct in statement, but that is not the way to go.
All right. Now let's talk ASUU, which of course is on the punch this morning. Says ASUU accuses federal government of deceit as minister explains payments delay. They have also threatened to once again go back on strike from Tuesday, the 31st of August.
In the last 2 weeks, when I've been this program, we've talked at the NAD, his rest doctors strike. You realize that every time I'm talking about that strike, I always mention ASUU and TU. I said NAD is going way of ASUU because the government signed an agreement with ASUU. Until today, they have not implemented that. And so for ASUU to come out now to accuse the government of deceit, and the minister tried to justify why that agreement has been implemented and payment not it. After several months, it's very fun talking about moving from central bank, the account, making payments. How long does it take to move money from central bank of Nigeria to accounts of banks? How long does it take in this digital age? I don't physically, even if they are going to physically move the cash from the America, from the United States of America, and they are locked in their treasury, I'm not thinking of taking a flight from the US to Nigeria, which is less than, which is about, the direct flight is just about 12, 13 hours directly from the US. Within 24 hours, that money was got into Nigeria. I think it was in the US. But in our own setup, a digital transfer fund from central bank account, and you say that it's taking time the rest of them. But that is the way, that is the job we have in place. That is the kind of things we see on a daily basis. That is Nigeria for you. A situation where the government signed an agreement with union and relate on it. The next thing you see the minister do is that he runs to the industrial court to ask for an injunction to stop the ASUU from going to strike, going on strike. ASUU was on strike for close to 1 year, not over 1 year. And they called off that strike and he had an agreement with them. The students are suffering. I will tell you that the fact some of those students, if those of them that entered the university the same time with the private university, most of the private students are already graduated. Why do other students, either in their 12 level, just going through their second semester, 200 level, or just signing in 300 level? Also, a full-day academic session was cancelled. It was cancelled. Most classes cancelled full-day academic session. Really large, so many of them cancelled things. That means that students have to stay back to repeat a whole year. And our ministers and our government are not doing that. If we are going to a situation where Nigeria practically going to self-help, education is not affordable, people have to go to private university. Electricity is not affordable, people resort to your work, there's no work that you can dig your borehole. There's no security, you have to draw over there. Where you live, you see that the street is now contributing for security, private security. That is what Nigeria has to. Everybody has got to serve. Government has totally collapsed in their responsibility to the city. And that is the situation we find ourselves.
All right, Chris Wanderle. Now, let's move away from ASUU's discussion and move to the judiciary. In the last few weeks, there have been some very shocking court judgments, ex parte orders here and there, stay of judgment, you know, from different states. And in reaction to that, the CJN, it's on the Nigerian Tribune this morning, it says, conflicting court orders. CJN summons chief judges of Rivers, Kebbi, Imo, Anambra, and two other states. Very likely to address these very embarrassing judgments that are being, you know, shared like party packs across the states. Quickly, also speak on that.
It's very unfortunate that we've been talking about the judiciary in this light. As a student of law, I remember in my 200 years that part of the constitution that I was taught is that the court of appellate decision cannot be able to annul or for whatever to give any judgment that has also been given by another court of the same appellate jurisdiction. You understand what I mean? If a court has given an order, another high court in any part of the country cannot give any ruling on that that has been made by a high court. If you have any problem with that, where it's in court of appeal. But a situation that where it has various judges within the same rank, give all sorts of injunctions, judgments, you get one from like the one that's happened to they got one from there, somebody else went to Kebbi and got one, another one went to Calabar and got that. The same court judge, nowhere in the world is done. And the problem has always been to the same. Our problem is it that of the constitution or those including the constitution? And most times people say, oh, the constitution. And I don't see that as the constitution. Because there's no constitution anywhere in the world. But our leaders and those that are with the responsibility of implementing the constitution, are they doing the right thing? And so it's quite unfortunate when you have these kind of things happening. And they are just exposing the judiciary to ridicule. And that is where the NBA, the AC has to come into play. The Chief Justice has summoned High Court judges from our 6 states. So let's see what we come out of that. But this is not the first time we are seeing it. It has look at the primaries in Anambra State, APC, PDP, RNB. Each and every one of these candidates will get all sorts of tumble. We go as far as Anambra, Medjugorje and the rest of the process of injunction, and which is needed, we just be considering the fact that the court even has that jurisdiction. That is not as what is called jurisdiction. You don't have a jurisdiction on a person, you cannot debate on it. And that is what is happening. So, I hope that the chief judges of the Federation and the agents will be the best as a deterrent to most of the judges that are just seen as judges and injunction. Injunction here and there, turning into just I don't know what to even say. Yeah. There be someone, let's see what the Chief Justice will come at on that.
All right, and now to the southeast, where it's reported on the Nation this morning, it says fourth week of southeast ghost mode turns bloody. I think it was about 2 weeks ago that, about a week or 2 weeks ago that. There was reports that the sit-at-home order had been called off and people should, of course, go about their regular business activities on Mondays. But, you know, even what two Mondays ago and, of course, you know, 2 days ago, another Monday, it seems like the Southeast, you know, a lot of parts of the Southeast are still adhering, mostly in Enugu, to the sit-at-home order. Where do you think this is going, and you know, at what point is this all going to end?
You remember the scenario I gave you, more like an update I gave you, I was 2 weeks ago, when I was talking about the money and the cup. I'm sure that is it. I told you about that. That is just like the cup have on your table there. You have put water and you see a monkey beckoning that, please kindly give me water. You send you to the monkey. I give the monkey the cup and he takes the cup. The problem is not giving the monkey the cup. The fact is that start drinking the water, you retrieve that cup from the monkey. You start dropping one branch or that one. You practically do. And that is the situation we find out in the South. We do the studies of us on that. When iPod started this, I was part of that say this was not necessary, this is not the way to go. But it is so obvious that people have lost initiative. They started this idea, and along the line, after the first thing, I said, oh, we'll call it off. Don't forget, the first thing they said was, oh, some students are taking NECO. So because of that, let us just allow them to go and take it. But at the end of it, people no longer listen to them. People have not decided to make it a good affair. And as I've always said, it's not because of that they want to adhere to whatever I put in. Because of that, their lives. Most of them feel that if they go on Monday, some false and colonies will come out and attack the key them. Some of them believe that it will be and open their shop. Some people will come and get it looted and set their new fires. And so the best thing they have is just for them to count their losses, just their soul that Monday. Irrespective of whatever iPod will say, and the second stage to it is they also know that the government of the state not protect them. If they believe that the government and civil agencies have what it takes to protect them from attacks, they will come out. But now, because of that fear, they have decided to go on their cousins and just say, let us just stay home this morning. Until there is no security and reassurance from the government, and the civil agencies, because of one day, they will have to they will continue to get that. And the indication is that the economy of the world is continuing to get protected on a daily basis. There are some people that get that on a daily basis, they don't go on a day, they will not be able to eat. So that is the situation of water. So any book about on a share, most of the part of the South is every day now is like a ghost. Nobody goes out, nobody tells anything because of the fact that of fears they will be attacked. Until the government and most of the South raise up to the facilities and let them look and come out with a firm sense that you are free to go about businesses every Monday that they are there to protect you. We'll continue to have this kind of situation.
Chris Wando, thank you very much. Always interesting hearing your perspective on major stories. We wish you a great day ahead. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you very much for having me. I do have a nice day.
Absolutely. All right, stay with us here on The Breakfast on PLUS TV Africa. Coming up, a little bit of history. What happened on this day, the 31st of August, many years ago. I'm going back to the year 1997 and 2015. We'll be back.